Operator, what do you want?
I'd like to order the hamburger platter with milk instead of a soft drink.
One hamburger platter with moo juice. It'll be there in a few. Anything else?
That's it. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, sure. Whatever.
I'd like to order the pasta and veggie platter with orange juice instead of a soft drink, please.
Health nut, huh? Well, whatever. Anything else?
That's it. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, sure. Whatever.
I'd like to order a Funday, please.
2,480 calories worth of sheer heaven plus one official Funday silver dish bone coming right up. Anything else?
That's it. Thanks a lot.
No prob.
Oh, that was so good. Instead of the chowder, do you think I could try one of those muffins?
Coming right up. Next one will be on the house, too.
That was delicious.
Here, let me get rid of that for you.
Think I could try a bowl of your clam chowder?
Coming right up. Next one will be on the house, too.
That was delicious.
Here, let me get rid of that for you.
First thing I'll need to make that cake is a mixing bowl. looks like I'm going to have to guess how long to cook it and what temperature to use. Perfect. Maybe I should try a little, just to be sure. I should put that icing Shorty made on it. What are these?
I made you that flour Frances mentioned in her recipe. I cut all the pieces out of marzipan using her old forms, but I'll be darned if I can figure out how the pieces go.
It's a tulip. What's this?
That's food coloring, so you can paint that marzipan flower.
Do you think I could have a piece of cake?
Sure. Help yourself. Tex really liked it, by the way.
Let someone else eat the last piece. Ah, loop-de-loop, otherwise known as soup. This smells delicious. That hit the spot. Bangers and mash, huh? Looks like sausages to me. I'm hungrier than I thought. That hit the spot. Looks like Pinky and Perky is turkey. I knew that. This smells delicious. That was really good. A meat pie. That dog's eye thing had me worried. Tommy's cooking is beginning to grow on me. That was really good. Do you mind if I make something?
Go right ahead.
Thank you.
So do you know what you want to order yet, Edna?
I'm still looking.
Did I tell you that my granddaddy was the engineer on a private train owned by one of the richest men that ever passed through Copper Gorge? Jake Hurley was his name. Yes, sir, my granddaddy was Jake's private engineer for more than 25 years. Told my daddy that men don't come any crazier than Jake Hurley. Yes, sir, Jake Hurley told my granddaddy things he never told another living soul. Not even his wife. I tell you about her, Edna?
I don't think so.
Camille was her name. Camille Boulet. That's French, you know. Of course, she died so young that poor Jake didn't have time to tell her anything. According to my granddaddy, one summer day she had a dizzy spell and fell and hit her head. She didn't take well to the heat, see? And sometimes in the summer, when they were going through the desert, why, that train would be just like an oven. The way my granddaddy died, that was kind of strange, too. I ever tell you how my granddaddy died?
No, I don't think you did.
My daddy, he came home from school one day to find a railroad official telling his mom that granddad been found dead in Blue Moon Canyon, Nevada. He was in the engine of Jake Hurley's train, just kind of slumped over with his hand still on the throttle. The strange thing is, nobody else was on board the train. Yet the door to the engine was locked and barred. It was like Granddad was trying to keep someone out. Like he was running from something. Like something finally scared him so bad his heart just stopped. I ever tell you about the mine my granddaddy said Jake Hurley'd found?
He found a mine?
A couple years before he died, Granddad put the crazy...
There. I finished making your tea.
Just leave it there.
Must be the mint that makes their edges turn up like that. I'll just cool the cookies off on this rack and I'll be all done. I'd like the croque monsieur.
Oui, mademoiselle. Ça fait 8 euros, s'il vous plaît.
You need to give him 8 euros.
Money well spent, I hope.
Ah, ham and cheese grilled on a baguette. One of my favorites.
Yum. Mmm. Mmm. As we say in the U.S., mmm-mmm.
Excusez-moi, mademoiselle.
The cuisse de grenouille sounds great.
Très bien. 12 euros, s'il vous plaît.
The price is 12 euros.
That's one less coin in my purse. Uh-oh, this looks like...
Frog legs. A brave but wise choice. They are magnifique.
If you say so. Mmm. Mm. You're right. The food here is good.
Excusez-moi, mademoiselle.
The crème de glace, please.
Oui, mademoiselle. Ça fait 5 euros.
That will be 5 euros.
Money well spent, I hope. Mmm, yum. Mmm. As we say in the U.S., mm-mm.
Excusez-moi, mademoiselle.
How about the cassoulet?
D'accord. Ça fait 9 euros.
Your choice costs 9 euros.
Money well spent, I hope.
Who can resist cassoulet?
Oh, boy. Mmm. Mmm. As we say in the U.S., mm-mm.
Excusez-moi, mademoiselle.
May I please have the cannelle?
D'accord. 10 euros.
The price is 10 euros.
That's one less coin in my purse.
Chicken dumplings. You are going to love them.
Yes. Mmm. Mmm. You're right. The food here is good.
Excusez-moi, mademoiselle.
I like the steak haché et pommes frites.
Très bien. Ça fait 11 euros, s'il vous plaît.
You need to give him 11 euros.
Bye-bye, hard-earned cash.
Ground steak, or what you Americans call hamburger. Without the bun, of course, and quite raw.
Oh, yeah. Mmm. Mmm. That was wonderful.
Excusez-moi, mademoiselle.
I get to make parfaits? All right. Okay, looks like I've got chocolate ice cream, vanilla ice cream, strawberry ice cream, caramel ice cream, bananas, tapioca balls, berries, and whipped cream. The first one I have to make is an exquis.
Parfait.
I'm getting there. Now they want a l'enfer.
Parfait.
He liked it. Next up, a tropical.
Oui, c'est ça.
Now they want a l'enfer.
C'est bien.
Next is a corbeau.
C'est bien.
He liked it. One mystique coming up.
Merci.
I did it right. Here comes a fantasy.
Parfait.
I did it right. A Lulu.
C'est bien.
I'm getting there. There, all done.
There we go. That was great. That ought to do it. And Frank says I can't cook.
Order up. Order up.
Thank you. Order up. Order up. Order up. Order up. Order up. Order up. Yum. Gosh, these things are good. Mm-mm-mm. Yum. Gosh, these things are good. Mmm. Yum.
A bowl of gumbo, please.
Enjoy.
Hot, but yummy.
Dive in.
Hot, but yummy.
There you go.
Woo, that was hot.
Interesting flavor.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm.
Cerotta, Vania, posso usare la tua?
Ma non lo so, le richiede a mio marito.
Uffa, senza il tuo marito.
Ciao, Antonio, dove stai?
Bene, bene, tu come stai?
Molto bene, ma
ci sono anche io. Ci dobbiamo prendere, facciamo la
You do fine work, miss. You do fine work, miss. You do fine work, miss.
Attention, everyone. As of now, the snack shop is open.
Mr. Harris was calling me up to his desk. Oh my gosh, I love when that happens. It lets you get a really, really good whiff of his aftershave.
Food, come get your order. Order up! Come get your order! Come get your order! There. All done. Okay, people. I'm ready to take your orders. A teacher order. I've got to get this one done fast. If I'm fast enough, I can earn a credit. Too slow, and I'll get a demerit. get your order. From now on, candy in moderation only. Mm-hmm. Nancy Drew, bento chef extraordinaire.
Yum. Yum. Wow, this is good. Wow, this is good.
I guess I could have one more bowl. I guess I could have one more bowl.
Yum. 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 That is so good.
Mm.
Mmm.
Great, just what Ryan wanted. Done. It's a masterpiece. That's all right. Wow, so good. Oh, that's really good. Wow, so good. Mmm. Yum. Yum. Wow, so good. Mmm. Yeah, that's all right. Yum. so good. Oh, that's really good. Wow, so good.
All right, let's see. Step one, 1 cup of sugar. 1 cup of sugar, 2 tablespoons of sugar. This can't be right.
I told you I couldn't keep up with her, so I improvised. I'm 100% certain about the amounts, though.
Let's approach this sensibly. What do we need? Cup of cornmeal.
Looks right to me.
1 cup of flour.
We're getting there.
1 spoon of sugar.
We're getting there.
1 spoon of sugar.
I think you've got it.
1 spoon of... baking powder.
We're getting there.
1 teaspoon of salt.
I think you've got it. That looks great. Let's tackle the next step.
All right. Second step. We have to fill the bowl until the weight is just right.
Quick heads up. This is about where things...
Hey! Let's... the next step. Finally, my favorite part.
I thought your favorite part was eating.
My next favorite.
Dear goodness.
Joe?
Sure thing. Going great, I think. Here comes some more. Almost there, just a few more to go. All done. They look super tasty. Let's eat.
Say the first Pharaoh director was so obsessed with ancient Egypt that he'd sleep on the set instead of going home.
Maybe he slept on the set because his wife kicked him out of the house.
No, he was happily married. That's what drove Lois Manson bonkers.
Have they put dog biscuits on the menu yet?
Ever get cold all of a sudden when you're on the set? You know, for no good reason?
Yeah, you too?
All the time. I don't think the set is cursed. I think it's haunted.
You know who I can't stand? The snake wrangler guy.
The snake sure seemed to like him.
Which is exactly why I don't.
I heard when that snake bit Lois Manson, she didn't so much as gasp. It killed her so quick.
Did you know that Lois Manson's body was buried along with the original Pharaoh's set?
Baloney. She's buried in Westwood. I've seen her grave.
They buried an...
Whoa. Our fearless director...
Aha! Tea-making instructions.
done with the tea? Very good.